So we're moving from an age where we write one story for a million readers to an age where we do a lot of the reporting and enable stories to be written for one person. The structure of narrative, I think, is going to change a fair bit. I think that that combined with, if you like, interactivity and data visualization means that the experience of getting information is going to change quite a lot. What won't change and what shouldn't change is the core journalistic skills of being able to find information, to ask the right questions, to think in the public interest, and to decide or to help think about what matters to people and what they should know, provide that information to them. I think those things won't change, but how we get it to people, I think that's where a huge seismic change in how information gets presented to people.
The future of journalism, I think, is collaboration now. It's no longer an industry where you sort of send the foreign person into Hong Kong and China to talk a little bit about and send home a dispatch about what's going on. You work with people with all different backgrounds and different languages and all different skill sets, from photography to video to text to research, to put out something together and collaboratively. So we are looking for people that can do that, that can work well with other people, that have all of these different skills, and that can synthesize all that together into something that the public wants to read.
For journalists in China, there's never a shortage of challenges, but we have fantastic stories to tell, and the tools we have today are incredible. Mobile enlarges the reach of our stories. Phones, VR, all the gears make the reporting job 24/7. Later this year, Caizhi plans to launch a new English language app, bringing top-tier finance and business news coverage and insights on China to the mainstream English world. Quite a few students of AIM are involved in the exciting endeavor.
We have been working closely in the past 3 years, or maybe more than 3 years now, on CIBS, which in long form is Community Involvement Broadcasting Service. And we invite people from the public, the communities, to apply for their own airtime to produce radio shows on RTHK DAB. We provide our airtime to you. We have already have our own transmission facilities, and we even subsidize people to produce the show. We have so far produced more than 2,000 hours of programs and broadcast on air. About over 100 groups, including NGOs, including private companies, hundreds and thousands of individuals being involved in the production.
It takes an enormous amount of investment to develop these technologies. Once they're built, you don't just leave them. They need constant updating, maintenance, refinement. And really it is then also freeing up the people to do more. I think increasingly readers don't just want to know what happened. Of course, they want to know why, and they want to know the context. If you've got a big group of journalists like we have, who have real institutional knowledge, have real expertise in a beat, you can apply their time and their expertise and their intellectual capital with explaining the news.
And in our industry today, you have to be digital and you have to be everywhere. Now, CNN, for example, is no longer a TV network. We are a digital media company that produces news for TV, internet, mobile, social, even VR. And we have to be everywhere because our audience is on the move. And as they move from one habitat to another, we must move with them. But how should students and young journalists prepare for the industry of tomorrow? Well, first, maintain an insane curiosity about the world and use that to pinpoint emerging areas to report on, whether it's genetic engineering or the rising political stars of China's third-tier cities. Now, second, you got to stay smart. Don't get stuck in the past. Constantly embrace the new and dare to experiment. You have youth on your side right now, but don't forget this 10, 20, even 30 years down the line. Embrace new technologies always. And lastly, don't undersell journalism. Our industry doesn't exist to merely chase traffic and eyeballs. I mean, part of being a journalist means trying to change the world for the better. So don't make it a race to the bottom, but an opportunity to bring about much needed change.